controls and cross-checking. Appreciate if you could pause any devices while we take you through the safety demonstration.
Welcome aboard. It's great to have you with us. At Virgin Australia, your health and safety come first. So we appreciate you giving us your attention as we take you through the important information that'll help keep you safe and comfortable on this flight. Let's start by talking about face masks. They might not be ideal, but they are mandatory. So thanks for wearing yours. Just make sure it covers your nose and mouth and that you keep it on throughout the flight. If you do forget, we'll give you a gentle reminder. Next, let's make sure your seatbelt is done up. It should sit low and tight across your hips. To fasten, push the ends together until they click, then adjust the strap so it fits well. To release, just lift the buckle. When the seatbelt sign is on, your belt should stay on too. And even if the sign is off, it's best to keep your seatbelt fastened, in case we hit a patch of turbulence. As we'll be cruising at high altitude, the cabin will be pressurized. If we do need oxygen, masks will drop from the unit above you. Immediately grab and pull the mask down to get the oxygen flowing. Next, remove your face mask, then place the oxygen mask over your nose and mouth, and slip the strap over your head. And while the bag won't inflate, oxygen will flow. Just breathe normally and remember to fit yours first before helping others. There's a life jacket under or beside your seat. If it's needed, retrieve it and remove it from the bag. Slip it over your head and pass the strap around your waist. Clip together and pull the strap to tighten. Once you're outside the aircraft, pull down on the toggles to inflate and for more air, blow into the mouthpieces. There's a light and whistle for attracting attention. As for infant and spare life jackets, we'll pass those out as needed. We're now going to point out the emergency exits. There are two doors at the front, four exits over the wings, and two doors down the back. Check where your nearest exits are now. They may be behind you. If visibility is low, escape hatch lighting will help get you there. Should we need to evacuate, leave everything on board. Taking your bags with you will slow us down and damage the escape sign. To find out about the brace position and other important safety information, have a read of the safety instruction card in your seat pocket. We ask that you follow the illuminated information signs as well as any instructions we give you. As always, smoking isn't allowed on any Virgin Australia flight. That goes for e-cigarettes too. All toilets have smoke detectors and alarms, so please, don't even try it. To help keep the aisle and exits clear, place all bags under the seat in front of you. If you want to keep using your handheld devices, just turn on flight mode. You can hold onto them devices are unplugged. From everyone here at Virgin Australia, thanks for flying with us. Okay, let's fly.
to the forward and the rear doors. If you are leaving through the rear door, you will have stairs to go down, so please hold on to the handrails and remain on the outside of the markers on the tarmac. If you're not comfortable with using the stairs, just stay seated and lead through the front door once it's clear. As we will be refueling, smoking and use of electronic cigarettes of any kind isn't allowed on the tarmac or anywhere in the terminal. You can now take your devices off flight mode, but make sure you try to use them on the tarmac. To comply with biosecurity in Tasmania, any fruit, vegetables, plants,